Greetings, everyone. Today, I want to show you how to make a high-quality and powerful CDI at home. This model, thanks to the use of 3 strong capacitors, produces a very powerful and high-quality spark, making it a great replacement for your motorcycle's CDI. Stay with me.
To build the CDI, we need these parts: C1, C2, and C3 capacitor is a 1 microfarad, 250 volt or 400 volts. C4 is a 10 nanofarad. C5, 100 nanofarad. C6 is a electrolyte capacitor, 10 microfarad, 50 volts. Diodes, D1, D2 and D3 is a 5408, and D4 is a 1N4007, and D5 is a 10 ampere diode. Thyristor is a BT 152. Resistors, R1 and R2 is a 1 mega ohm, R3 is a 47 ohm, R4 1 kilo ohm. And finally, we have NTC here. This is a temperature resistor, 1 kilo ohm thermistor. In this circuit, I use a BT152 because it can handle higher current and voltage. Let's draw the diagram. We need a PCB board in 5 by 7 centimeters, and the parts are placed on the board in this way. AC power from the stator go to the D5 positive. D5 is a 10 ampere rectifier diode. It's for protecting the voltage backflow to the stator. After that, go to the C1. We have a 3 big cap here. I use a MKT capacitor. Other side of the C1, go to the positive of the D1 diode. And from there, go to the negative base of the D2. We have a kill switch here. C2 and C3 with the R2 connect together. And from there, go to the ignition coil. Other side of the C2 and C3 connect with R1 resistor, and from there go to the anode base of the thyristor. The anode base of the thyristor go to negative base of the D1 and D3. The positive base of the D3, D2 and D4 connect together. The negative base of the D4 go to the C5 capacitor, and from there go to the R3 resistor here. Other side of the C5 and positive base of the D2 connect together and go to the ground. We have a negative base here. One side of the R3 go to the pickup trigger input. C6 is a electrolyte capacitor which have polarity. the negative base here, and this is a positive base. The positive base of the C6 go to the R4, and negative base go to the R4 and C4. You have an NTC here. This is a temperature register. Gate of the thyristor and cut of the thyristor go to the NTC, and from there go to the C4 capacitor. The cathode base of the thyristor also go to the D2 positive base. This base of the R4 resistor go to the R3 and C5. The diagram has finished. The reason I draw a diagram this way is so everyone can understand. Let's go to build this PCB.
Let's test it.
Alright friends, we've reached the end of this tutorial. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it and share it with your friends. Also, be sure to leave your comments for me. If you're interested in this type of educational content, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. On this channel, I create educational videos about upgrading and modifying motorcycle electrical systems, repairs, interesting electronics projects, and DIY builds that you can benefit from. See you in the next video. Goodbye.